Good afternoon. Today in Especiales, we're having a special guest, a plastic artist and architect whose name is Henry Borges, who has had a trajectory as an artist for more than four decades. He studied art at the Arturo Michelena Art School, and he also got his architectural degree in the ULA, University of Los Andes in Venezuela.
Bueno, ante todo, un gran placer estar con ustedes. De verdad, es emocionante este momento. Y bueno, aquí estamos para compartir un rato por todas las cosas y por todos los medios.
He says he's very pleased to be here and to share with us different ideas about everything that is happening in Venezuela, specifically in the art realm. It is interesting to have you here today, because behind the hand of the artist, there is an architect with a different perspective about art and things. So my first question is, who is Henry Borges?
Bueno, mira, Henry Borges es una persona normal que desde joven, desde muy pequeño, me he inclinado por la pintura desde muy temprana edad. Y desde muy temprana edad también he ido participando, inclusive desde los colegios y los liceos donde estudiaba cuando estaba pequeño ya participaba. Paralelamente también seguí mis estudios normales y llegué a la universidad y me gradué de arquitecto. Y realmente la arquitectura influyó bastante, bastante en el arte que hago. Debido a eso, el arte mío está enfocado directamente con lo que es la arquitectura desde el punto de vista de las imágenes, de la simbología, evitando todo lo que son los tecnicismos y las prácticas rutinarias y monótonas de lo que es el hacer, de lo que es muchas veces el hacer de la arquitectura. Estoy buscando un nuevo rumbo, una nueva forma de hacer arquitectura.
He says he's just a normal human being. He's like everyone else around him. He was interested in art since his very early childhood, and he participated as an artist even in elementary and high school. Then, after he finished his regular studies, he went to study at college and university and got his degree as an architect. Architecture and being an architect has been a great influence in his options for art, because he sees everything from a different perspective, since the architectural perspective, beyond what is metal shapes and forms, he wants to go beyond what art and architecture is. Nowadays, it is a phenomenon that Venezuela is opening new spaces for art. You can find art pieces like paintings and sculptures everywhere, health facilities, corporational spaces, everything. Besides, in Naguanagua municipality here in Valencia, they have art pieces of art for the people to see. For Henry Borges, what's the best or the ideal place to exhibit art?
Esa historia que está ocurriendo con la difusión que ha habido en Venezuela, últimamente ha habido más difusión del arte hacia los espacios urbanos, hacia los espacios arquitectónicos y hacia la enseñanza también, es muy interesante porque una de las razones del arte es la humanización, el compenetrarse con el ser humano, con la sensibilidad, con la labor social que tiene que cumplir, y la única manera es que el arte le llegue a la gran mayoría de pobladores. Eso se logra con que el arte se encuentre en espacios públicos, en espacios abiertos, en los mismos espacios corporativos que tú has mencionado ahorita, porque es interesante e importante que toda la población de todos los niveles tengan contacto con el arte, y no solamente contacto con el arte, sino también que de alguna manera se enteren qué dice la obra de arte. Eso es importantísimo, importantísimo. ¿Dónde debe estar una obra de arte? Donde haya la mayor cantidad de gente, porque mientras más gente lo contempla, más labor se logra.
For him, it is important the diffusion of art in the urban areas, in cities and around. His idea is that art has a social function in the society, and the best place for him to have art is not only the corporate areas or the social areas, but everywhere where common people can see them and go beyond painting to the real meaning of the piece of art. You have already said that art is accessible and it creates different expectations in people who appreciate art. Either those people have a remarkable knowledge on art or just an onlooker of art. We know that common people can appreciate only shape and color and maybe forms. Besides, people who know more about art can go beyond just the painting of the colors and getting to the real meaning of the piece of art. Since that point of view, can you tell us something about the code of communication that art might have in the language itself?
Esa pregunta es bien interesante porque quien tiene más visión y quien tiene más capacidad de invertir y quien tiene más capacidad de apreciar el arte, ya con trascendencia en el mundo entero, invierte en arte y al mismo tiempo esa inversión produce que se difunda más, no es a nivel local, sino a nivel mundial, y se aprecia más el arte. Y bueno, realmente hay que hacer una inversión en arte para que se difunda, y bueno, y esa es parte de la vida. Parte de la vida es el tema económico, y el arte no se escapa de ahí, pues. Y eso lo ayuda muchísimo.
It is important that art can be appreciated by everyone. The diffusion of art and the pieces of art is very important. That is why it is for the people who know about art, the intention of buying art, paying for it, make it known everywhere through the diffusion that they make when they buy a piece of art. That is very important, the economic part of art, because actually art has to be sold and purchased.
Hay como un código de comunicación que es realmente, en el caso del arte, lo que mueve muchas otras cosas, muchos otros proyectos, porque en ese momento de reunión hay una gran inspiración, una gran motivación, porque se está en medio del arte, que es algo de mucha sensibilidad. Y esa sensibilidad se transmite completa a todos los seres humanos y se pueden lograr muchas cosas, muchos proyectos en un ambiente realmente humano.
It is important what you have already said, because it might be said that a common code is created among those people who are, as you said, sitting together where new ideas are generated. Besides, from those meetings, other things can be created too, such as motivation and creativity among those people who are there to appreciate a piece of art, and not only for them, but for everybody around them. Now we're going to listen to some music, specifically a delicious jazz selection made by our team. And when we're back, we're going to know what brings Henry Borges here to World Trade Center Valencia Open Spaces.
Wonderful, marvelous, you should care for me. Awfully nice, it's paradise. How I long to be. You make my life so glamorous. You can blame me for feeling morose. Wonderful, marvelous, that you should care for me. Wonderful, marvelous, you should care. So glamorous, you can paint me for feeling amorous. Oh, wonderful, marvelous, that you should care for me. Wonderful, marvelous,
Say we're really pleased here in Especiales to have Henry Borges, a master of painting and also a sculptor too. We would like to ask him what brings him here to the open spaces of World Trade Center Valencia in this opportunity.
En esta oportunidad traigo solamente pintura, traigo 32 obras en acrílico sobre lienzo, como algo enfocado netamente a lo que es la arquitectura desde el punto de vista de las imágenes simbólicas, de las imágenes oníricas y de imágenes completamente ambiguas desde el punto de vista del arte. En mediano formato y un gran formato, hay dos tamaños de obra, pero básicamente son lienzos, acrílicos sobre lienzo.
In this opportunity, I'm bringing to World Trade Center Valencia 32 pieces, only paintings, based on painting acrylic on canvas. All of them are focused on images from the city, but not just as the city, but the oniric images, the symbols that can be seen in the city, and that might be considered some kind of ambiguous since the art point of view. So basically what he's bringing is acrylic on canvas in different formats, middle size and small size ones. Two questions for you now. What's the main topic of the painting you're bringing, and how long are your pieces of art going to be displayed here at World Trade Center Valencia?
Mira, el título se refiere directamente a lo que es el caos urbano que hay. El título de la exposición es Ciudad Directo, sin ninguna duda. Ese es el nombre de la exposición. Porque a eso se refiere, a la ciudad sin tapar nada, simplemente como lo expreso yo. El tiempo invertido, tengo obras inclusive del 2012 hasta la fecha y con más intenso trabajo en 2015 y 2016. Eso es lo que estoy presentando ahorita.
The name of the art exhibit he's showing here in World Trade Center Valencia is named as Ciudad City. And it's his conception of the city itself, naked, with no beautiful things portrayed or shown. Basically, he wants to show the urban chaos that you can find in any city around the world. The works they are presenting now came from his work during the years 2012, 2015, and maximally from this same year, 2016. So you can appreciate his personal vision on the chaotic city where he lives. You are bringing us 32 pieces of art that will be displayed here in the open areas of World Trade Center Valencia, which has also been characterized as displaying art only for important people. Only important artists can get here and show their work. That qualifies you as one of those very important people in art in Valencia and in Venezuela. We would like to ask you something very important. Behind every artist, there must be an art curator. Who's the art curator who works with you?
Sí, el curador de esta exposición es el crítico de arte, él es historiador y crítico de arte, miembro de la Asociación Internacional de Críticos de Arte, don Luis Cubillán Fonseca. Un señor conocedor, como bueno, mucha gente lo conoce, él es muy conocedor de lo que es el arte, la historia. Él está siendo el curador, en este caso, de mi exposición.
The curator in this presentation that he's giving is the historian and art critic Luis Cubillán, who is a member of the International Association of Art Curators. He is a very important person here and around the world, and he's the one who is behind the artist for this display. You are talking about Luis Cubillán, who is well known not only here but internationally. And he has been known as a person who is really, really critical and very selective at the moment of accepting an artist as part of his work. So we would like to congratulate you for having such an excellent person as the art curator of your place. We know that logistics for your art exhibit is something that is not easy. It's not something that you can do in a second. We would like to know, well, who's the staff that's helping you for your art exhibit, or said in other words, who are the little workers who are behind the artist for the presentation and the exposition?
Mira, sí, hay un gran equipo detrás de todo esto que siempre lo acompaña a uno y como en todas las buenas acciones y en las acciones que se pueden difundir, tiene que haber un equipo. Mira, en el equipo, la primera persona que de verdad está en el equipo es el señor José Rodríguez, que junto al equipo nos ha brindado un gran apoyo y una gran oportunidad, como es la del World Trade Center en el Salón Mezanina, que es un salón de mucha importancia. Y detrás de la exposición tenemos en primer término al curador, que es el señor Luis Cubillán. En fotografía tenemos al señor José Antonio Rosales, muy conocido en el medio artístico de la fotografía. En la impresión de catálogos y todo eso tenemos al señor José Galarraga con su empresa cooperativa de ingeniería venezolana, experto en diseño y todo este tipo de cosas. En el montaje de la exposición tenemos a mi hermano, Pedro Pablo Borges. En la museografía tenemos a la diseñadora Adriana Cruz. Y bueno, y en la parte más pequeña estoy yo echándole pinceles a las pinturas.
First of all, it's important to say that making an art exhibit, it's not really easy, as Milangela said. Firstly, we have Mr. José Rodríguez, who gave him the opportunity to display his pictures here at World Trade Center Valencia. He offered not only these open areas for that, but also his complete support in this endeavor. Secondly, his art curator, Mr. Luis Cubillán, who has helped and supported him during a lot of his art trajectory. We have also mentioned in the pictures for the art exhibit, we have José Antonio Rosales. Regarding the brochure that is going to be given to the people who attend the presentation, we have José Galarraga with his company, Ingeniería Venezolana, who helped with all the printed material regarding the presentation. Besides, in the setting, his brother, Pedro Pablo Borges, who is the one who helps him to set all the pieces in the correct order. Besides, we have a designer who was in charge of everything regarding the presentation, whose name is Adriana Cruz.
Y con este equipo que está aquí en la radio, con la señora Milangela Sequera, muy agradable, y la intérprete Alejandra González.
Finally, the people here at WTCV.net Radio, World Trade Center Valencia. The manager of production, Milangela Sequera, and the person who is making this interpretation into English, Alejandra González.
Cuéntenos, ¿dónde es la cita, la hora, para poder ir a deleitarnos con lo que Henry Borges trae al espacio World Trade Center Valencia?
We would like to know the dates for your presentation here in World Trade Center Valencia. Date of the opening and time.
Bueno, mira, se inaugura este jueves 26 a las 7 de la noche en el Salón Mezanina del Hotel Hesperia Valencia y estará al público hasta el 25 de junio de este mismo año.
The opening of the art exhibit will be on May 26th at 7 p.m. at the interfloor area of the Hesperia Hotel Valencia, and it will be open for the audience to come and appreciate his work until June the 25th. We would like you to tell all the people who are listening, not only the people who knows about art, the connoisseur of art, but also for those people who just appreciate the art as something new, or those who are initiating themselves in that wonderful world of shape, color, and art. What would you like to tell them?
Mira, invito a toda la colectividad carabobeña y nacional de cualquier estatus que se acerquen y observen, porque es una exposición de arte. No es otra cosa, y eso es para toda la humanidad.
He's very grateful for being here and being interviewed here at the radio. And he says that he would like to invite everyone that can come nearby, come and see it, because it is art, and art can be appreciated by anyone, and is part of what makes us human beings. We would like to thank you again for being here with us for this amazing interview. Here at the radio WTCV.net, World Trade Center, Valencia, Venezuela. And we would like you to tell all the people who listen, where can we find you in the social network, in the internet?
En el blog, pueden tomar nota, henryborges.wic.com/henryborges. En el correo, artistashenryborges@gmail.com. Y el teléfono 0414-342-2866.
He says that you can contact him at his email, artistahenryborges@gmail.com, in his blog, henryborges.wix.com/henryborges, and you can also contact him with his phone number, international code 58-414-342-2876.
Agradecido de esta oportunidad, de esta entrevista, de esta difusión, porque esto es lo que hay que hacer con el arte.
Nos escuchamos en un próximo especiales.
Si das tú.